Ben, welcome. So, there's
thank
a lot
you.
Of talk. First of all, tell us a bit about what you actually do at Omnicom.
Yeah, so I'm the SVP of Marketplace Intelligence. So it's a unit that specializes in strategy and analysis, and I head up a lot of our thought leadership efforts at the holdco level.
Okay, so it will not have escaped your notice. There's a lot of talk in the TV space about a shift to multi-currency market. Do you think you and your agency peers are broadly comfortable with the direction of travel?
I would say so. The way that we talk about it is that it's a land rush, and land rushes happen when there's a moment of unusual opportunity. Land rushes also tend to be messy. So what we're trying to do is make sure that the way that this plays out, our clients have the benefit of all the technological improvements that this new generation of measurement providers offers without some of the downside risks.
So you heard Mike on the scene setting panel earlier talk a little bit about his anxiety about truth sets. You know, if we have three different numbers for the same show, which one's right and how are we gonna know? Does that trouble you?
It's something we talk about a lot internally, like not to name any names, but when we compare ratings from different measurement providers for the exact same airing of the exact same program, there are very large discrepancies. I actually think we were talking about that at dinner last night. So it does trouble us. The only answer is to have a framework for evaluating different measurement providers to try to work through this, and maybe we'll talk about that in a minute.
And just to tease that out, what might that framework look like?
Yeah, so we've got a four-part framework that we've introduced our measurement partners to. So there's reliability, so how stable is the measurement over time. There's accuracy, so how closely does it hew to what we believe is a truth set. There's cost, of course, because that can't be ignored. And then there's transparency.
Right.
How much insight do we have into the underlying data sets and then how those are being transformed into an aggregate measurement?
And agencies are becoming much more active partners in measurement, aren't they? You have measurement partners and relationships with many of the vendors here today.
Indeed.
And you also have relationships with TV platforms and streaming services, which sometimes for certain campaigns allow you to have access to data in relation to those campaigns.
Mm-hmm.
And all of that, I'm going to ask you, does that lead to a somewhat asymmetrical, uneven market? In other words, are we going to have a much broader ecosystem of measurement solutions and services, which will vary really quite widely?
Yes, there's definitely going to be a market characterized by more providers than what we've become accustomed to in the past. So that's not necessarily an area of concern. What we want to make sure is that it's not a checkerboard of a marketplace. Like if you imagine, you know, the major sellers on one axis in a grid, and then the major measurement providers on another. Right now, if you look at the alignment and support for measurement providers by different major sellers, it's all over the place. It's not consistent. And so what we're hoping to get to is a world where our advertisers, our clients, have the option to use any measurement provider we think is a reasonable solution with any seller. Because if we stay in this world with a highly fragmented landscape of uneven support, we're actually going backwards in some ways.
Do you think we're going to end up mourning the day when we had one dominant currency, or absolutely not? We're heading to a much better space. More measurement is better measurement.
Right. Well, there's definitely no guarantee that more measurement is better measurement. I don't think if we went from 10 measurement providers to 100, that would necessarily be an improvement, right? But what I would say is that we've certainly observed in various corners of the media market is that competitive segments of the market tend to be better for our clients than uncompetitive ones. And so the hope is that we can have the benefits of competition while still having some of the consistency and reliability that we've been able to benefit from in the one currency world.
And final question before we move on. For your clients and the advertisers you work with, what specific improvements do you think they're getting excited about when they see what's happening in this space?
There are a few, and I think Lisa did a great job of touching on them in her session just now. One thing is greater precision, which is distinct from the point about greater accuracy, because if you've got relatively few distinct commercial airings because you're in a broadcast paradigm, you can have really good accuracy with a panel that's not that large. But as we continue down this journey to addressable advertising, it's going to lead us to more and more fragmentation of commercial airings. And so that means that a big data approach becomes necessary to accurately measure all the nuances of the various commercial airings that are going on simultaneously. So that's a big one. And then another thing is the idea that our clients will have the opportunity to select, like, which measurement provider is best for their particular criteria. Because what we're seeing as this space develops, I mean, I'm sure we'll hear about this more in the next session, is just that different providers have different underlying data sets, and that gives them each a unique profile of strengths and weaknesses for different measurement use cases.
How are they going to know?
Well, that would be the transparency point, we would hope, right? We would hope that we'd have full disclosure from each of these measurement providers, like, you know, we're getting data from this OEM, we're getting data from this other data broker, whatever. And so by doing that, we can see how good the alignment is of the data sources with the ultimate use case that our advertisers are going to be using.
Wonderful. Okay, Ben, you've set it out really clearly. Thank you.